Greetings everybody, Okami Games Online. Welcome back to more of The Legend of Zelda, Oracle of Ages. Last time, we started going through the Mermaid's Cave and I really screwed up. In this episode, I took the time to go to this room, aka one room right above, or now two rooms above the entrance. And I'm not happy. I'm very not happy. First, the dungeon map's there. So that's the first mistake I made. The second mistake I made is, well, everything I did in the last episode, pretty much. Because I got impatient, I tried to beat the dungeon quickly, and in the end, that ended up costing me. And because of that, we're splitting this dungeon into two episodes. But, in any case, what we want to do is not get grabbed by a wall master. Or I guess these guys are floor masters. But we want to go here. And we need to use our switch hook to get down here. It's dumb, I know. We want to go down here. There is a puzzle here. I'm saying here a lot. And the puzzle should be decently straightforward. At least I think it is. Push that up. Push that. Oh, come on. This is gonna be a bit fun to do, isn't it? Do that. Alright. Now we just need to get glue here. Which is like that. With that done, we got a small key. Thank God. At least we're making some progress in this dungeon, which, to be fair, we did get through most of this dungeon in the last episode. But a few stupid mistakes is enough to throw you off your entire game. If this isn't any indication, considering I was planning to get through this dungeon in the last episode, but nope, I had to be an idiot. Alright, now that we're actually being decently smart, do I need, no, I don't need to go, what am I doing? I'm gonna go this way, I'm gonna keep swimming very far this way. We want to go down here. We're going to drop down. Kill you. Kill you. I really wish there was an item I could use to just teleport straight to the center of the dungeon, but otherwise I just have to use the save and quit. Not the most efficient way, but you know what? It works. Because I'm going to be using it here in a bit. Because if we go over here, right here, hope we get lucky. Okay, so yeah, pull these. You die first. And there's the key. Boss key! Yeah. Really is the most efficient, isn't it? Let's just use save and quit. Well, at least now we have that, we are ready to take on the boss. So let's get out of here, please. Actually, Maple is here, so I missed Maple last time, so we might as well try to get something out of this. That's nothing of importance to me. Yeah, the drill fastest one wins. And I can't get that rupee. Fine. Alright. Back to the past. I'm just, like, torn down now because of all this stupid stuff I've been doing. How are we doing on heart pieces anyways? 0 of 4, alright, so I'm missing a few. I'll have to go look for those later then. For now though, it's time to head off to the boss. Kill you guys, because you guys suck a lot. Wanna go this way, we want our King of Samaria. to go away. I'm running low on health as well. That's not good. I think later on we can find a fairy, which will really help, because I would really hate to die a second time in this dungeon. I hear that that's not a good way to go about doing this. Anyways. I am just... And then that happens. That's exactly what I wanted to see in this dungeon. Clearly, nothing wrong with that. Now we have to go through this entire puzzle again. At least the Wizzrobe seems to not respawn. So that's one nice thing. Let's just do that. Alright. It's Rockfeather. And this room again. Let's not be dumb this time. Again, I hear that's a smart thing to do from time to time. You die. Oh crap, and I can't even use my sword for a few seconds. Fantastic. Alright. Fine, fine, just take hits, just go. Okay, well, that was very, very sloppy, but we did it, and at this point you should have two keys, I do believe. Which, fortunately I have two keys, and that fairy also helps. We want to use one of our small keys here. And the other one here. So now, what we need to do is this. Get your Canister Mario ready. Do that. Then place one down. Because when you step on, every time you step on the switch and step off the switch, this thing will rotate. So that's why the Canister Mario. Yeah. And now, we have to do that. For some reason as a kid, that's the thing that gave me the most trouble in this dungeon. In any case, boss time. Starting off this fight against Octagon, yes, that's seriously his name. When he turns his back to you, you want to slash at him. Which, yeah, it's a thing. Right? But then he will also dive underwater. When he does this, you gotta do the same and just get slashing him again. Slashing enough, he's gonna resurface. And this is really all there is to this boss fight. Like, not even joking. This is all to this boss fight. He's already dead. It's probably the easiest boss in this game. Anyways, there's a heart container, and we are finally done with this dungeon. Thank God. You got the Bereft Peak, an essence of time. It is a proud, lonely spirit that remains stalwart, even in trying times. Link, I have great news. Queen Ambi has just left the palace. Now is your chance. Maybe your only opportunity to save Nehru. Well, looks like we have our next objective in mind. Let's go ahead and use Gale Seeds. So we need to make our way to Queen Ambi's palace now. That is our next goal here. So, let's get moving. I'm gonna go this way. And up this way. And it's Ralph. Link, don't startle me. You also heard the guard on the house was down and came to save Nehru. Anyone who's gonna save her, it's me. I won't let you beat me to it. But it's no good entering from the front door. I know, there should be a hidden entrance in the palace garden. I'll sneak in through there. What? Why do I know about the hidden passage on my first trip here? Never mind, I'm coming, Nehru. Well, let's follow Ralph. Now we're entering into Queen Ambi's palace on our own will. This is very interesting. Now, one thing you want to do is right here, there's a Sensei tree, so not a place for us to teleport to. The idea is we need to step on all these switches. And there's 4 of them in total. So, we want to try to step on all of them without being seen. That is the basic idea here. So far, it's not being that tricky. If you are seen, then the guards will throw you out. So, I hear it's a good idea to not get seen. Now, let's go over here, and this looks like it could be a bit complicated. Or not. Alright, that's 3 switches. Now we just need to get the last switch, which should be up here. Go that way. Alright, that's all 4 switches. That really was not difficult at all. Oh, I could possibly be in a bad spot. Okay, never mind. Alright. There's a path down here. And let's dive on down. Move right on forward. Swimming areas are always fun, can't you tell? Alright. We go through here, and we're now inside the palace. Which, while inside the palace, there are a few things you can do. First, if guards see you, it's not that bad. They will chase after you, but if you attack them enough, they will run away. But they also, that's not as much damage as I was thinking, but they can easily combo you. That's the thing you gotta watch out for. But I do believe, going this way, I really don't care if I get seen by the guards, because they are not that difficult to deal with. Because I can just do this. Alright, right here, we're at the boss. Yeah, we have a boss. You're going to want to equip your mystery seeds and your switch hook to start off with. Link, I am amazed you have come so far. Wait. Do you mean to turn your sword on me? Ha ha ha. If you want to hurt Nehru, then go right ahead. Starting off this fight against Nehru or Varen, what we need to do is we need to follow Nehru around, and we need to do that. Not bad, but as long as I'm in Nehru's body, you cannot harm me. Which means I'm invincible. Well, let's do that then. You gotta use your switch hook on Varen, then slash her. And you gotta do this 3 times. Pretty straightforward. Alright. Now let's switch hook, attack, equip. It has to be specifically mystery seeds, I'm pretty sure, by the way, just FYI. Keep following you around, you're gonna do that. Alright, good, sword. Switch hook, and down goes Varen. Ugh, not bad at all. Just wait until next time. What is this commotion? Ugh, Link? Where are we? Are you truly Nehru? You seem different. You seem nice. The queen comes with impeccable timing. The body of a queen suits me just fine. Do you know what I'm going to do now? Let me tell you. Meet the petrified ones. I shall catch them all. Pokemon! Guess this wouldn't be the best situation to make to joke about that in. Nehru! Is it you? Is it really Nehru? Ralph, I'm sorry to make you worry. I'm fine now. Let us return to our own age. What are you doing? Catch them now! Thank you, Link. You've safely pried me from Varen's grip. Now all the strange things that happened in the land should return to normal. But Link, Garen's still in the past, right? If she is, then can't she still create an Age of Darkness that would continue to the present? Sorry, Link. I was the one running around while you did the saving. But know this, I'll be the one to stop Varen. I won't leave the people of the past to her evil deeds. Forgetting about Varen now would be foolish. If we do, she'll just come for Nehru again. Ralph, just like you said, I'll help in what little way I can. Link, you have the Harp of Ages. I want you to keep it for now. I'm sure it will continue to aid you. Now let me teach you the last tune, which will unlock the true power of the Harp of Ages. You learn the Tune of Time. Play it to move back and forth between past and present. Choose it when you use the harp. Link, you fool! As we guessed, saving Nehru was for naught. Ambi's age is filled with cries of sorrow. Varen has extended the Dark Realm's reach, giving us what we seek. Echoing cries of sorrow. Spread darkness. Spread sorrow. What was that? I can't take this, Link. I'm going back to Ambu's age first. May fate bring us back together. Bye. There's little else I can do, so I'll return home for now. Stop by anytime. What's going on? What does it mean if they're behind Varen's deeds? Link, the next essence. That's weird. An essence is echoing from inside a fish. Inside a fish, eh? Well, we'll go look for that later. But there is one thing I want to go over about the Tune of Ages. Well, besides the fact that it makes the other two tunes completely useless now. This is all you need for the rest of the game, as far as the Harp of Ages goes. But one area we did not explore in the past was what is present-day Yul Graveyard. So what happens if we play the Harp of Ages to go back to the past while in the Yul Graveyard? Well, let's find out. Sent back by a strange force. Yeah, we cannot go that way. The other area, there's another area that does the same thing, and that's if you try to teleport between time while at the Black Tower. Or in the Black Tower area. But anyways, now that that's done, there's one last thing I want to do before we end off this episode. And that is another heart piece. We want to go to the sea. Oh yeah, and there's one. Well, that's a. It's an item that's in the past, so we'll get that next episode. But we want to dive underwater because if we look around here, right here, there's an entrance which leads us to this area. But what is in this area is the question here. Well, if we follow the area, and it is a bit of a maze, so. Alright, we want to go down from here, I'm pretty sure. Go left, go up, and then just follow this... Oops. Just follow this path up. Alright, now go this way. There's a treasure chest. Inside is, excuse me, a heart piece. Alright. So... let's just go ahead and make our way out of here. And that will probably about do it for this episode. We got through the Mermaid's Cave, and we got a new tune. And, well, we also saved Nehru. Unfortunately, now Varen has control of Queen Ambi, which can also be, well, very bad. So, next time on The Legend of Zelda, Oracle of Ages... we're going to be getting the last few side questy stuff that we can do. And we're going to shove off for the 7th dungeon. See you guys then.